after heavy mopping in the kitchen and actually doing all the housework.
Bullshit.
Right. Cooking with Kev. This is not really cooking, this is actually snacking. And look, I'm a savoury man and I like to eat crisps. So I'm going to attempt to make some crisps today. Well, I say attempt, I have tried a little batch before and it actually works out, but I've got a secret ingredient that after I've cooked the crisps, that I'll show you how I flavour them. So literally, I've chopped them up. I'm not going to show you how to chop up potatoes, but I've sort of done them. I don't know, that's a bit thick really, a bit like me. But I've tried to make them like, I'd say like a 1 millimetre thick. So what I'm going to do now, I'll just put them on a plate and I'll show you exactly what I'm doing, but I'm not going to show you me putting them on the plate. And see you in a second. Right, like I say, I'm not going to show you me putting it all over, but what I'm going to do is fry like all over the plate. So as I'm cooking them, hopefully they don't stick to the plate. I'll see you after. There we go, that's what I'm doing. So with this dish, I'm going to show you exactly where I'm going to cook it in 1 second. Amazingly, just in the microwave. Now, something along the lines of 1 to 1.5 minutes, but you've got to judge it yourself, depending on the power of your microwave. But literally, I'm going to say 1.5 minutes we're going to do this for. I'm going to turn it around. And then after 1.5 minutes, I'll show you what's happened. Obviously, 1.5 minutes is not quite enough. So I'm going to do another 1.5 minutes and let's get going. Right, so 3 minutes in, what happened was, which I didn't bother showing you, but all the water was come out of the potatoes now, which I've just sort of slowly tipped down. Not enough to burn my hands or anything, just enough to let all the water dribble off. Now I'm going to go on with Fry Light, the Slimming World friendly Fry Light, over the top, and then hopefully this start the actual crisping up. So there's 3 minutes, going to go in another minute and a half, be back with you. Yeah, another minute and a half, very looking soggy still. It's a bit of a bald ache to be honest, but it's a lot easier to open a packet of Walkers. Still, if you want your craving with sin free, bear with us. Back in. So 6 minutes so far, and what we're going to do, we're going to turn them all. Bit of a bald ache still, but if you want a snack, you've got to go for it. So I'm not going to show you, but that's what I'm going to do. We're going to turn them over. This is not tried and tested. So this is, as you see it, I've done it on small amounts, not this amount. So see you in a bit. Well, I've turned them all over, and then what I'm sort of working out as this video progresses is potatoes hold a lot of water. So when it comes down to this point where you feel like you need to turn them over, I think it's a good idea to let all the steam go out of them, let them cool down a little bit before you put them back in, which I've done now. They're going to go back in. So I think we've done 6 minutes. There's going to be another, I'm going to put in 2 minutes. That'll be 8 minutes in total. So as you can see, these are starting to go, these ones here. They're a bit thick. They've got to be about 1 mil thick. So I think you're better off with one of them sort of slicers that can actually do things to precision. This is hand cutting. So I don't give that one any chance, but I'll give this one here a bit of chance. Like I say, it's a bald ache, but if you're in good company like me and Nicky are, and you fancy a bag of crisps instead of opening Walkers, let's make a, well, we're making a video out of it, but make an event out of it. Enjoy it. Outside's doing well, inside's not doing so well, so I'm going to swap around, still boring you, but at the end of the video I'm going to show you a quick way of doing it as well, because I'm just doing it in mass. There we go. Right, that's it. Well, like I say, I've done little amounts before. This time I'm doing a big amount, which is not really working as planned. I want it all to be consistent. Like that one's nearly there, and some ain't. So I'm not going to... I'm just going to keep cooking. When the crispy ones are ready, I'm going to take them off, but I'm not going to keep showing you. There's not much more I can say, really. It's not working out to plan, but like I say, I'll show you the quick way after. But this is what I'm doing now. So, that's it. Right, there, these done. Absolutely beautiful. While I'm reviewing this last bit, them two's going to go in 2 minutes. But what I've also bought recently is Saxa, and it's new salt and vinegar spray. So you can make these at home. And I know it's a bit of a ball ache, but if you've got the crisp rush, then go for it. Got a crunch, tastes like salt and vinegar, because that's what it is. If you've got time and not in a rush to do that, it's well worth it. Now I'm going to spray this in a dry one with that. Good. This, which I've only just discovered, is free on Slimming World as well. Would that give you your craving for crisps? Is it worth the ball ache?
Yeah.
So now, this is just because I've made minimal just for this video. I didn't realise that takes so long. That's 2 minutes in there. It's still a bit soggy, but I reckon they'll dry. There you go. It's nearly sort of drying. There we go, it's turning crisp now. Right, so my suggestion is don't do that amount. Just take your time. It's not ready to... I'm doing it in real time, but there you go. You know, it's got the crack. And that was in real time, that one. Absolutely beautiful. So don't try and do too many. If you've got time on your hands. Come to time for work, just put salt and vinegar in it. Ah, you bastard. Fuck, that fucking hurts. Shit. Oh, please stop that pumping. Can't believe she kept filming. We're going to do another microwave one, and I'll put it out there tomorrow. And happy days. But yeah, give them crisps a go, because I know how the cravings get you. I'm a savoury person, not really a chocolate person. Although being on the diet has made me have a sweet tooth. That is what I like. That's what I like to snack on, and you can do it. You can make slim free crisps, and the only thing that I don't understand is why it's not out there and why it's not actually sold in the shops. Either way, see you later, guys.